Thank you so much, everyone. That was a tune, maybe one of the first songs I ever wrote. It was called Nina. And how about a hand for Rachma Lim playing beautifully on the first solo on that. And special thanks always to Rachma because she encourages me to play original music, which is really rare. You know, we don't always get to do our songs. So that's why this is the Trojan horse session, because we're sneaking it in our original music. And then we have an amazing singer, Karena, who's going to make it easier to handle by playing some funky stuff for you at the end of the night. So get nice and loose and enjoy the vibes and just, you know, treat us like we're your backdrop. But, you know, tune in when you can. And thanks for the applause. We love applause. Musicians love applause. Yeah, thank you. It's true for our souls. So speaking of which, this next song I wrote is called The Soul Collector, and you know, I collected most of the Blue Note records. I tried to get, you know, all of them at one point on CD, and then you find out, oh man, we don't need CDs anymore. We got our phones, so it was a big waste of money and time. But that's the first collection thing. So we all collect something, right? We all have shopping addictions too. We all have all kinds of stuff. But this is my tribute to collecting, you know, Blue Note records and stuff like that. And I'd like to dedicate it now to Wayne Shorter, who passed this year. So he was one of our great jazz heroes. So this is called Soul Collector. Thank you. Thank you so much. It's really wild to have like good friends like this, you know, they listen to the recordings and, you know, do more with the recording than what was on the actual recording. So, and I do have some recordings. They're on Apple Music and Spotify under EJ Hughes. So if you want to hear this song, it's there. And hopefully someday a version with these guys, you know, will be there too. So the next song we're going to do is off the same record I did. Actually, no, this is a different one. This is a song I wrote for my daughter, but not intentionally. This is a ballad that I wrote for a friend of mine. His baby had cancer in her cheek, and we thought she was going to make it, but she did not make it. It was kind of sad. So her name was Audrey. So years later, I ended up naming my daughter Audrey after this Audrey. So this is a beautiful ballad, Audrey, based on the song Once Knew. So I'm going to let Rachma take it away with some piano introductions while I switch my saxophone here. And this is Audrey, so hope you enjoy. Thank you. next song, we're going to feature our amazing pianist, Rachma Lim, who's been such an amazing supporter of me since I got here. And, you know, I'm just really indebted to her for, you know, giving me a chance to play original music, as I said, and also just being a really great friend. So how about a hand for Rachma? Probably most of you guys are here for the last one, because she's just an amazing person and an amazing artist. And sometimes, you know, we artists are hard on ourselves, so we never feel good enough. And Rachma and I sit and talk about that all the time. We're like, you know, just trying to strive to be better. This is a beautiful song she wrote about where she lives. It's a place called Esperella, or that's the name of her block. So, did you want to say anything about it, Rachma? Just playing it? Yeah. As Miles Davis said, we'll play it first and tell you what it is later. So this is Esperella. Thank you. So sorry, my glasses, you know, are so far from my sight, I'm like, trying to struggle to read, but it's such a beautiful song, and thank you, Rachma, for letting us play that tonight. This next one is, when I was in my master's degree studies at Georgia State, I'm really blessed because they, you know, they let me come one semester in 1994, and I decided to go to New York City instead, and then I came back in 2001, just around when the trade towers and all that in New York City was rough. But, you know, my director at Georgia State said, yeah, come back and we'll give you an assistantship, you know, to help teach. So I started doing this research class, and we were in the library all the time, back when we used to go to libraries. And I found this book, and it talked about two pentatonic scales in Japanese culture, and one represents the yin side and the other the yang. So this melody that I wrote is called Inyo because it's the two different pentatonic scales. And kind of in the style of the John Coltrane group is how we're gonna kind of open this up. So hope you enjoy this. This is called Inyo. Thank you. The Trojan horse has arrived and the soldiers have come out and attacked you guys with all kinds of different sounds. So we're gonna bring Karena up and we're gonna do this song called Easy that she taught to me on a Korean gig that we used to do every Tuesday. So I don't remember what I used to call it, but I don't even know the name of it. So how about a big hand for Karena Yeo on vocals coming up.